But none of us can break through our own models of the way the game goes enough to do the things necessary to bring about that realization. And it's only when there is enough that we can become back to we, both of us as subjects, and experience the unity when we are truly collaborative about our resources, the understanding that there is no they, there's no other. It is all one. And it's really what happens here is there are a lot of experiments in psychology with figure ground. That is the relation of the background to what stands out, right? Now, in our culture, we've been trained for individual differences to stand out. So you look at each person, immediately it is brighter, dumber, older, younger, richer, poorer, and we make all these dimensional distinctions, put them in categories and treat them that way. And we get so that we only see others as separate from ourselves in the ways in which they're separate. And one of the dramatic characteristics of the psychedelic experience is being with another person and suddenly seeing the ways in which they are like you, not different from you, and experiencing the fact, well, yes, indeed, we are brothers in the true sense of that which is essence in you and which is essence in me is indeed one.
What's this do to the free enterprise market system?
Well, what it does, if I understand it right, is it moves the basic motivation from an achievement, competitive, to a collaborative kind of enterprise, which means that I'm not working in order to beat you out, but you and I are working in order to both make it. Now, at this point, we're still, I'm aware that you're a separate individual from me. We're separate, but there is something similar. Right. Now, at this point, there is this start to break down of the separation, the different separation between us. For example, I might look down, and this is another an external hallucination. I will see my body disappear, right? Or see those ways in which I am different become like learned things that I wear, like this sweater. For example, PhD. What does that mean? All right, it means I got a certain kind of education, acquired a certain degree for being more educated than 0.1% of the world's population, something like that, all right? And that assures me of something or other in society, right? In fact, it's a garb I wear. If I had the gown and the cap, you know, that would be the external symbol of that same thing, right? Now, that gown is a psychological gown I wear, just like Richard Alpert is a gown I wear. You know, it's an identity that I've taken on. I wasn't born Richard Alpert. I was just born as a human being. And then I learned this whole business of who I am and whether I'm good or bad or achieving or not. All that's learned along the way. And you see all those learned things separate. So you start to have this dissociative experience of where all that you become is awareness, is a point of awareness. It's all that's left. I remember the first time this happened to me, as professor went and middle class boy went and pilot went and all of my games were like going off into the distance, I got this terrible panic because indeed I was going to cease to exist. And I got the panic, which is the panic that precedes the psychological death, because indeed Richard Alpert was dying at that point. And the panic was, no, stop, stop, I've got to hold on to something so I'll know who I am.